Plan International Uganda, with support from Plan Belgium, has been implementing a project called Reach Every Mother and Child with Nutrition in Emergency. Plan International implemented the project in collaboration with Adjuman local government and communities with the purpose of helping South Sudan refugee children, youth, women and girls to realize their rights in safety and dignity during and after crisis in the refugee and rescue communities.
By name, I'm called Lalia Jane, the in charge of the facility of Agojo Health Center 2. Agojo Health Center is around 3 kilometers away from the camp. At first, our health center has been, not being supported by any other organization. But when Plan came in, they brought a lot of activities for this place, where the nationals and the refugees were so grateful. They have done a lot for this facility. They have been organizing activities in the camp where the refugees also benefit a lot from it, because the health facility is very far from the camp, where the old ones could not even come here. But when we take the activity to the camp, those old ones were able to also access. Plan has trained very many mothers who are now able to give support for other mothers who are not able to take care of their children properly in case of nutrition. They are able to prepare now meals, good meals for their children to become healthy. Those are the things which I can recall, and the staffs also are also well trained now. They can also give health talks, they can even demonstrate how to prepare the food for the community and the refugees as well.
The scope of work included outreaches, parental sessions, food demonstrations, and using the PDF model.
My name's called Atmak Florence Ida. When Plan reached in our village, they give us the seeds. It changed my life because now I get enough food. A special genex, I get about eight sacks, and then maize, I get 15 sacks. So I think that will be help me with the school fees, even for eating.
The project area included Agojo settlement and 4 villages in the host communities, which included Biamba, Marera, Duba, and Agojo Central. The project had 3 components, nutrition, wash, and child protection. The entry point was the ECCD centers and caregivers of the ECCD centers.
My name is Mercy Konait Kasim. I'm from Agojo Refugee Settlement Camp, Block 2. I'm a refugee from South Sudan. Well, the situation before was actually not good. Yeah, before plan came in, we do go to the health center. We access the health center by footing. But some of the people who cannot walk from here to the health center, since the distance is very far, so they cannot access the health services, meaning that they have to at least use some money for transport. Now, if you don't have for transport, meaning that you cannot access the health centers because there's no ambulance here which is helping the sick people to go from here up to the health center. But since now Plan International has brought for us the outreach, so we can access the health services near at our camp here.
The intervention targeted children 0 to 14 years, with special emphasis to children 0 to 5 years, pregnant and lactating mothers, with special interest in the teen mothers. The other beneficiary group were the men.
My name is Sisi Kam, the National Program Manager of Health for Plan International Uganda. In Uganda, we have five program country programs, and health is one of them. Under health, nutrition is one of the priority areas that we are focusing on. And with funding from Plan International Belgium through the national office, we secured funding that has helped us to reach every mother and child with nutrition in emergencies. This project is called REMARK in full. It's called Reach Every Mother and Child with Nutrition in Emergency. It has actually helped us to reach so many people within the community because of its model of working. We have used what we call the PD Health model, where we go into the community. We find people who are facing the same challenges like others, but for them, their children are not malnourished, meaning that they are deviating positively from the rest of the community. We select them out, we give them skills on how to communicate and also give them the basic facts about nutrition, and then they act as the champions of change for behavior change within those communities. One of the things that I've also liked in this project is about the community outreaches, which have actually brought the services closer to the communities, especially in the refugee communities and also in the host communities. Before, you find that the health facilities are very far from the communities, and people have to walk as long as even 8 kilometers in order to reach the health facility. But now, when we took the outreaches within the community, so many people are able to access services, and these services within the outreaches were integrated health services. The other best component, which was actually very good within this project, was about the food security component, where both the nationals and the refugees got seeds for vegetables and also for food crops in order for them to secure food within their households to fight malnutrition. We have also actually realized that the land in Germany, in West Nile, is a fertile land which can actually even act as the food basket for the refugee communities. If we look at areas like managing the post-harvest spoils, this project has been a success, and we have seen that the people have been trained already in the community, and they'll also remain in the community, giving information about nutrition to the fellow community members, and also helping them to know how to do it practically, helping to do food demonstration in the community, so that our children in the community are not malnourished. I would like to say thank you very much to Plan International Belgium through the national office, who have allowed us, who have granted us this funding that has enabled us to reach every mother and child with nutrition in emergency. Thank you very much.